The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 17, 1975, in Vrindavan, India.
So, Sri Bhagavan Vasha, Bhagavan, this word, I'll explain many times. Bhagavan means the supreme authority. So far, authoritative power is concerned, that is analyzed by Srila Rupa Goswami, 10% power or 10% qualification is in Krishna. Krishna Pur Bhagavan Sayam. There is, this is called Sabhishesh, personal analysis. Not that in somebody, he sometimes has addressed as Bhagavan. That does not mean he is also equal to the Supreme Person. Just like sometimes Narada Muni is also addressed as Bhagavan. Lord Shiva is also addressed as Bhagavan. Not only Vishnu Tattva, but also others, sometimes they are addressed as Bhagavan. But in order to particularly point out Krishna, it has been said in the Srimad Bhagavatam as Krishna Su Bhagavan Sayam. Krishna, actually Bhagavan is Krishna, because he has got 10% qualities of Bhagavan. That is analyzed in Chaitanya Charitamrita. The 10% Bhagavan. Other, they are also Bhagavan, Vishnu Tattva, Narayana. He is also Bhagavan. But Srila Rupa Goswami has analyzed is 94%, not 10%. Or, in other words, you can say this, that Sarayasanya Purna, that is Krishna. And there are also Sarayasanya, but it is not displayed. Not that, it is like Lord Ramchandra. Lord Ramchandra, Madhyadaku, he also Bhagavan. Ramadi Murti Sukalamiyamina Tishtham. Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is existing as the Supreme Person, along with Rama, Shiva, Varaha, many thousands of avatars. They are also Krishna. Keshavadhita Rama Sarira Jaya Jagadisha Hari. Keshavadhita Meena Sarira Jaya Jagadisha Hari. So, Keshava Krishna, he existing with all the incarnate. Not that he is existing as Krishna. So, when we speak of Krishna, we take it that all his expansion and incarnation. Therefore it is said, Ramadi Murtisu, Kala. They are Kala. Kala means partial expansion, not full expansion. Full expansion means full. So they are also Bhagavan. But Krishna Sri Bhagavan Swami, Bhagavad God, The authority of Bhagavan is fully expressed in Krishna, not in others. Therefore, when we Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, and after making the list of different incarnations, it is summarized that Hidesha Amshapala Amsha Krishnasu Bhagavan. All these incarnations mentioned, Rama, Devati, Kalani, Amani, Krishna, they are partial expansion and expansion of the expansion or expansion of his power, Saptavish Avatar. That's Lord Buddha. He is Saptavish Avatar. Many Saptavish Avatar. So in this way, Krishna is always existing along with his expansion and incarnation. But the real original personality of Godhead is Krishna. Krishna is Bhagavan. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita is being spoken by Krishna. But enough to distinguish it. Badly, he writing, see Bhagavan. He does not say Sri Krishna Bhagavan. Just to make it distinguish the Krishna through Bhagavan. So, we are placed to receive knowledge from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is our mission, Krishna consciousness. Really, knowledge given by Krishna. Idam tute duryatamam parvakshami samasuya. Now I am giving you this knowledge. Very confident. Duryatamam. Duryatamam means confidence. And duryatamam, more confidence. Comparative superlative. Quality comparative superlative. Guya is quality. Guya Tara is comparative. Guya Tama. So, we Brahma, Brahma Gyan is Guya, is very confident. Because if you achieve Brahma Gyan, immediately you become the most important person within this material world. Brahma Guru, Brahma. And Brahma Guru means above Brahmana, Brahma. So that is Guhyam. Guhyam means consciousness. To become Brahma Bhuta, Brahma Gyani, that is Guhyam. And Brahma is Paramatma. When you understand Paramatma, Ishara Sarva Bhutanam Vitesha Vina Sustati. Paramatma means Atma and Paramatma. There are two different souls. One is Paramatma means He is present everywhere. That is Paramatma. The Maharaji says there is no difference between Atma and Paramatma. But that is not the fact. Atma means present within the body. I am Atma, you are Atma. Dehin asmin tatha dehe. Asmin dehe, in this body. I am Atma, you are Atma. But I am not Paramatma. Paramatma is different. Paramatma is Krishna, or the Supreme Personality of Godhead, situated in everyone's heart. So that is Guhyatara. First of all, to understand Brahma Jnana or self-realization, that is very confident. That is not ordinary knowledge. It is above ordinary knowledge. That word is a guyon. Guyon means very confident. Nobody understands. Even Atma Tattva. Atma Tattva. Sutumbhyam jayanda dhinashati samasata. Apashyatana Atma Tattva. Griheshu Griyome Dhinna. Griheshu Grihome Dhinna. Those who are living within the family life, they cannot understand what is Atma-tattva. Avashyata. Avashyata. Minam Shanti Sar. Sukhdev Goswami is advising to Parikshit Maharaj that there are many things. They are busy, just like ordinary man, worldly man. He purchases a huge volume of newspaper and he is interested. But he is not interested to understand Bhagavad Gita where Atma Tattva is described. They are not interested. Therefore, Sukadeva Goswami said to Parikshit Maharaj, Sutta Vyadi, subject matter for here. Ninam Shanti Sahas, for ordinary man, there are thousands of news. You can see so many magazines, technical, musical, cinema, and ordinary news, and so many editions of every newspaper in every city. So this is a fact. Sotukbani Tanajitya Vinam Santi Sahasra. Sahasra means thousands and thousands and thousands. Why they are busy with so many newspapers and why they are not interested in hearing Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam? Because apasyatamātma-tattvam, they did not know that the real purpose of life is to understand ātma-tattvam. Apasyatam. Why are forget? Griheshu, grihamedina. They are married a vow that to maintain the family and to have some enjoyment from family life. Family life means society, friendship and love. That Vidyapati's song, what is that? Can you remember? Kāpala saikate bāyīndu sama sutta mita ramani sama sutta mita ramani sama. This exact English equivalent is society, friendship and love. Everyone is busy. Society, family, friends, country, nation, community. In this way, sutta mita ramani sama. And what is the composition? Children, sutta, mita means friends, and ramani, some omen. In their beautiful woman, that is also very nice. So they are busy. They are busy. The other day we have been just in Hyderabad. He is very busy with the Sutamita Ramani. Everyone is busy with Sutamita Ramani. So somebody can say, unless there is happiness, why people should be interested? There is happiness, certainly. So that happiness is compared by Vidyapati, the great Vaishnava poet. So it is just like Kāpala Sarikate Vāyibindu Sama. Just like desert. You have seen desert. Desert means it requires huge quantity of water. Nowadays, practically, in every country, especially in India, Every land is just like interior, for want of water. So, you see, Vrindavan, so much land lying vacant, no Jesus. Why? There is want of water. There is no sufficient supply of water. In this way, if there is scarcity of water, then gradually these places will be converted into desert. So, the desert water is used because it requires huge quantity of water. Similarly, we are in this material world. We are trying to be happy in the society centered on love, sutta-mita ramani-samana. But the happiness we are getting, that is compared with a drop of water in the river. In vast desert, Arabian desert, you say that we want water, and somebody brings a drop of water and takes it. It will be very insignificant and no meaning. Similarly, we are, our heart is desire, real pleasure, transcendental bliss. So if we are put into the desert, sutta-mita ramani-samadhi, what is the benefit? This song is confirmed in the Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam that āpaśyatāmāpaśyatam, they do not know what is the aim of life. They are satisfied with this drop of water in the desert. It is never material. Desert is very vast tract of man's grass. And if somebody says, all right, take one drop of water. No, what is the meaning? It has no meaning. Similarly, we are spirit souls. We are hankering after Krishna. That is our inner desire. And what happiness we shall get with this society in friendship or love? That is not possible. That is not possible. There is some happiness, temporary happiness, very small quantity, so-called happiness. It is never satisfied. Actually, we are trying to get, because we are eternal, we are trying to get eternal happiness. That is Krishna is speaking here. Jnanam priham of Harijnana parvakshami on a suya. Anasuya means asua means angel. Everyone is angel of Krishna. That is demand. That's why Kamsa. In this tract of land, Mathura, there was Kamsa. He was so angel that he ordered his servant that as soon as Krishna is born, please bring the child. I will teach you. This is also. So at the present moment, practically the whole world, they want to be gods. The scientists and everyone is trying to prove that there is no God. There is no Krishna. This is our sentiment, especially the communist kind. So if you become demon, communist, in favor of that, then you are also infected with asura, envious of Krishna. Then you cannot understand. Then you cannot understand. Krishna is very strict. But the devotees are very religious. Krishna doesn't want to speak in his demons. But the devotees are so kind, they go to the demon and pray, kindly hear. Kindly hear about us. This is therefore a devotee is more merciful than Krishna. Krishna doesn't speak to the demon. Unless you are one bhakta. It's like Bhagavad Gita spoken to Arjuna, Bhaktosi, Sakhasi, Krishna Dayatri. Krishna is very strict. But the devotee, the fact says, Jayamam Paramam Vyam Mad Bhakteshwam Dayatri. About Bhagavad Gita, he says, one who speaks this confidence and knowledge among the bhakta, he recommends the bhakta. But the devotee, they're so merciful, they go to the abhakta, transgressing the order of Krishna, because they are so merciful. All right, Krishna has rejected them. Let me try. Let me try. This is the position of abhakta. They are not only unenvious to God, but they are also unenvious. Therefore, their name is Karuniko. Karuniko. Most merciful. they describe Titiksam. Karuniko. Suridhar Sarvabhutana. Devotees are always tortured by the demons. They are prepared to torture even Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and their devotees. So they tolerate all these tortures. Therefore, the devotees are described as Siddhikshama. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also teaches, Tinagati Sunichino, Sarorabhi Sahishno. The devotee should learn this sloka of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that he should be tolerant more than the tree. Karma. they take the risk of preaching amongst the demons, non-devotees, because they are karunic, very much, more merciful than Krishna. More merciful than Krishna. Krishna says, don't speak this Bhagavad Gita to the non-devotees. Because non-devotees will not accept. Krishna says, Sadhu Dhaiman, Purishta Jumani, Kamsanam, he will accept. Unless he is devotee. The Mayavadi, Kundi, Jnani, Yogi, they are not accept. They are envious. I am God. Why shall surrender to Krishna? Why shall I accept Krishna as God? This is the position of the bhukti-mukti siddhita. Therefore, you find so many yogis. They can play jugglery, magic, but they are not devotees. They will not surrender to Krishna. This is there. So such person cannot understand. They cannot understand the science of Krishna. They cannot understand. Because Krishna does not disclose himself to the non-devotees. So by their own attempt, however big yogi or jnani or kodmi he may be, he cannot understand Krishna. Krishna discloses, reveals himself to the anasuya way, one who is not envious. And that is the one. Anasuya way means the one. Who does not, who is not envious of Krishna. Others are envious. Kurmi Jnani Yogi. The Kurmi will say that you work hard and get the result and then you are. Why you are going to the temple to pray? This is the philosophy of the commons. Why should you go to the church? Why should you go to the temple? Forget all these things. Work hard, earn money and enjoy life. But that demonic. Because there is enemy against God, that demon. So the science of God, or science of Krishna, Krishna Tattva, is never disclosed or revealed amongst the non-devotees demon. It can be revealed, it can be understood by a person like Arjuna. Therefore it is said, Anasuyabhi Jainam Tiham Prabhakshami. Anasuyabhi this very world, we should never be envious to Krishna and his devotees. If you think that I am envious to the devotees, but I am not envious to Krishna. No, no, Krishna doesn't accept that kind of thing. You, first of all, you should be non-envious to the devotee. Madhvakta pujam bhavika. If you are envious to my devotee, and if you become a devotee, that is not. That is stated. That one is directly devotee of Krishna, he is not devotee. One is devotee through his devotee, he is. This philosophy is of love. You cannot say, why can I go through Guru or through Vaishnava to Krishna? I can go directly, I am so qualified. No, you are not qualified. If you jump over like that, then not. That is in Bengal, it is a ghona dinge ghaska. There is grass before the horse. If you think that if I jump over the horse and eat the grass, that is not possible. So, one should be devotee, first of all. Satvijnanasamsa gurumeva virakshe. He must have brought a bona fide guru in order to understand the science of Krishna. Avirakshe, this I have explained several times. So, anasuya. If you want to learn Krishna, then you should be very much humble and submissive to Krishna and his devotee. Jnanam vijnanam. Jnanam, this knowledge, most confidential knowledge, it is not sentiment. Vijnanam. It is science. Just like in scientific knowledge, you must know theoretically and practically. Not only that, you simply know that so much oxygen, so much hydrogen produces water when mixing. That is theoretical. You have to make water by mixing these two chemicals. That is practical. So in the BSc examination, the strict examination test theoretical and practical. So theoretical is, Krishna says, Sarva dharmam paritajya mamekam saranam paryam. But when you really surrender, there is practical science. That is practical. If you decide to surrender, that is called saranagati, then you have to learn the science, how to become surrender. That is vidyan. Jnan means theoretical knowledge, and vidyan means practical. So you have to do it best. Not that I have read Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavad, so I have become. No. You should practically demonstrate in your life that you are actually good. That is called vijnana sahitam. Jnanam vijnana sahitam. Just jnantya. If you learn this science, just jnantya. Moksha se asubha, the result is, you become liberated from this asubha, inauspicious condition of life. Asubha. What is that? Inauspicious condition of life, with material. If you want to get out of this materialistic world, which is asubha, there is no subha. People are thinking we shall make it subha. Subha means auspicious and material adjustment by having nice car, nice road, skyscraper building, and so many machines and with bodily comfort, which is known as material advancement. But the sastra says it is all inauspicious. All inauspicious. If you want to become free from this inauspicious kind of life, then you should learn this science which Krishna is teaching, jnanam vijnanam, not this vijnanam, the so-called materialistic science. You should learn the real science, savijnanam, that is, how to surrender to Krishna, how to become not envious to Krishna. This is a great sign you have to learn. And that is spoken in this chapter, 9th chapter, the science of Krishna consciousness. If you become expert in the science, then you become free from this inauspicious science. This is material science. Thank you.